Hi viewers, welcome back to our channel A to Z Dentistry, Dental HS Medici. As you know, today is our topic of discussion central ossifying fibroma, which is benign lesion which comes under connective tissue pathology. Craniofacial bones are the common site for ossifying fibromas. It is of two types. First one is central and the second one is peripheral. Peripheral ossifying fibroma we have discussed on earlier video, which is seen commonly on gingiva, comprised of 9% of the total gingival growths. Coming to our today's topic, that is central ossifying fibroma, which may arise from endosteum or periodontal ligament adjacent to the root apex, and it expands from the medullary cavity of bone. Despite of the similarity in terminologies, it is not considered to be the counterpart of peripheral ossifying fibroma. Why? The answer is, peripheral ossifying fibroma, as I mentioned in my earlier video, is a non-neoplastic enlargement of gingiva and which is a reactive hyperplastic inflammatory lesion, while central ossifying fibroma is a true neoplasm of bone. Moving towards the key features, synonym for central ossifying fibroma is central fibroosteoma. It's a true neoplasm of bone. And before confirming it as central ossifying fibroma, you must exclude fibrous dysplasia and other fibrosis lesions. Central ossifying fibroma shows cell proliferation and osteoblast with bone formation, while central cementifying fibroma shows cell proliferation and cementoblast with cementum formation. Central ossifying fibroma can be seen on young adults. Both maxilla and mandible may get involved with slight predilection for mandible. Considering about the sex, males and females may get this particular lesion with slight predilection for females. There is a high incidence rate in black population, and the key feature of central ossifying fibroma is it is a asymptomatic lesion and it is having very slow growing. Central ossifying fibroma radiographic features. We are having a well circumscribed lesion which demarcated from the surrounding bones. Initially, we will be getting unilocular or multilocular radiolucencies. Later, flecked with opacities. That means they are having more and more depositions. Finally, we will be getting uniform radiopaque mass. In this OPG, you can appreciate the lesion on lower left back region. Coming to the histopathological aspects, we are having key feature is mitotic figures. We will be seeing so many mitotic figures in central ossifying fibroma. Normally, we are having large number of plump proliferating fibroblasts, which may be intermingled throughout a very delicate fibroblast stroma. We will be also seeing small fossae of irregular bony trabeculae. So, when considering this particular lesion, treatment of COF is conservative excision. Now I am moving towards few histopathological diagrams which shows central ossifying fibroma. As you know, ossifying fibroma means you will be seeing so many collagen fibers, fibroblast, and in case of central ossifying fibroma, definitely you will be getting more amount of mitotic figures along with calcifications. It can be either dystrophic calcification, cementum formation, or even bone formation. First diagram shows bony trabeculae. Second diagram shows globules of calcification. Here in this diagram, you will be seeing high cellularity. High power shows plump proliferating fibroblast along with mitotic figures. Budding capillaries can be also appreciated. Small loci of calcifications is also evident in this particular picture. Thanks for watching.